Welcome all for yet another video, Dr. RS and you, Science of Cosmetics and Personal Care Products. Today, we are in part 46. We will be discussing about Coltrim, which is the exactly opposite to the sensory of vanishing cream. Vanishing cream, a dry, matty feel, and Coltrim, oily, occlusive feel. Coltrim. So, Coltrim, we are in part 46, Coltrim. Before that, I want to just caution you, formula mentioned are only suggestive. User should conduct all relevant studies before using the formulations, right? So, I am just discussing some formula which is only suggestive formula. So, you have to do a lot of studies, modifications before you use it, right? Obviously, I have worked in industries and I can give you only the hints of what you can do. I can't give you the final stabilized tested formulations, right? So, those formulations are indicative formulations. You can take from there and you can then use it. Right? So, they are not the final formula. Right? So, Coltrim. Right? Coltrim, originally this name is due to cooling effect that these products have on the skin. Comprised of a group of emulsions that are related to cleansing creams in the USA and moisturizer in Europe and other parts of the world. So, Coltrim is always seen as a cleansing cream in USA and moisturizer in Europe and other parts of the world. As a moisturizer, Coltrim forms occlusive layer on the skin, seal moisture onto the skin and reduce transepidermal water loss. We saw that. Three ways of moisturizing the skin. What are the three ways of moisturizing the skin? Supply moisture, seal moisture, improve the inherent nature of the skin to hold moisture. So, extreme winter, when the external humidity drops, the skin tends to lose its moisture. So, the moisture that extreme winter, you can seal it by applying occlusive layer. Vaseline petroleum jelly is one such. Coltrim has evolved with better sensories. So, forms an occlusive layer on the skin, seal moisture onto the skin and reduce transepidermal water loss. As a cleanser, with beeswax borax acting as a surfactant and with high level of oil and water content, Coltrim removes makeup effectively. It also cleanses dirt, sebum, dead cells and other detritus from the skin and help to keep the skin healthy. Right? That is how it acts as a very effective cleanser also. Right? So now, history of Coltrim. See, Galen in 150 AD first invented Coltrim with animal and vegetable fats and oils. Beeswax and olive oil was originally used, but no emulsifiers were used in the formation. The preparation was laborious. Found the product is becoming rancid. Subsequently, olive oil was replaced by almond oil. And later, borax was introduced that stabilized the product and manufacturing time was reduced. Right? This is how. Then, USP 15, United States, USP is United States Pharmacopoeia. In the monograph of USP 15, Coltrim type of formulation was labeled as rose water ointment, right, which contained spermaceti 12.5, beeswax 12%, expressed almond oil 56%, borax 0.5, rose water and distilled water. and rose oil, right? Spermaceti is from sperm whale. It's a waxy material from sperm whale, right? So this is the formula that came official in United States Pharmacopoeia in 1955. Subsequently, in USP 18, Coltrim formula was published, substituting almond oil with liquid paraffin. Substituting almond oil with liquid paraffin, and rose water was excluded in the formula. So almond oil was substituted with liquid paraffin, and rose water was excluded from the formula. Right. So Coltrim had various formulations, has had various modification from a simple formula to a little more complex formula. So very simple formula: beeswax, mineral oil, borax and water. So here oil, water phase added to oil phase. Okay, so beeswax and mineral oil, they are taken in the main vessel, borax and water in the side vessel. So both the phases are heated to 75 to 80 degrees. The water phase added to the oil phase. Then during addition, there should be a vigorous mixing. So the formulation was simple, and subsequently some of the beeswax was substituted with paraffin wax, right? 8 plus 7, 15%. And this was the formula subsequently. Cetyl alcohol was introduced. Obviously, in these formulations, the spermaceti was not there because spermaceti was from sperm whale. So the availability was a problem. So spermaceti was excluded. Cetyl alcohol was included, and paraffin wax. And further evolution, they introduced non-ionic emulsifiers also into the formula, right? So beeswax, borax, emulsion, additionally with non-ionic emulsifiers like tween and spans, right? So that is how it evolved. Then, beeswax, borax, right? We will see about these two ingredients in detail, right? Beeswax and borax. Chemical composition of beeswax, right? It contains 71% wax esters, myrcyl palmitate and myrcyl esters, right? 10.5 to 13.5% hydrocarbons, C13, C29 and C30, right? It's a very long chain. Free fatty acids, cerotic and melicic. This is very unique to beeswax. Free fatty acid, cerotic and melicic acids. 1 to 2.5% higher fatty alcohols, cholesterol esters, moisture, minerals and coloring matter. Mainly 1,3-dihydroxyflavone, it's a coloring matter. The palmitate, myrcyl palmitate and myrcyl other esters, cerotic acid and melicic acid, very unique to beeswax, right? So quality of beeswax, especially melting point and acid value, right, is critical for its product characteristics. But British Pharmacopoeia, melting point 62 to 65, Indian Pharmacopoeia 61 to 65. But the acid value specified, they are totally different, right? Acid value is contributed by cerotic and melicic, right? Melicic acids. Now, this is the most important thing, because these are the acids that interact with borax, right? The borax level is based on the acid value of beeswax. So the melting point and the acid value contributes lot to the quality of cold cream you make, and you have to decide which, what is the acid value of the beeswax you are using, standardize that, and that should be used. As a natural product, batch to batch consistency in specification of beeswax is critical, right? Beeswax is considered as an animal product. Now again, the use of beeswax became little difficult because recently batch to batch quality of beeswax was widely varying. Two, beeswax is considered as animal product, and claiming vegan became difficult in the cosmetic product by using beeswax, right? Now, so beeswax borax emulsion is unique. Borax is chemically sodium borate and it neutralizes the fatty acid of beeswax. The interaction of beeswax and borax is much more complex. A lot of theories have explained how beeswax and borax interact in cold cream, right? However, substituting borax with alkali like sodium hydroxide to neutralize the beeswax long chain fatty acid results in emulsion of totally different characteristics. So this infers that the neutralization of the beeswax fatty acids, cerotic acids and malic acid, by borax is not as simple as just neutralizing with an alkali. So it is much more complex, right? Again, the manufacture of this beeswax borax emulsion, as long as you make this emulsion in the lab, it worked very well. But industrial manufacture of beeswax borax based cold cream is highly process sensitive. I was talking about the reversal of emulsion. I have seen when you add water phase to the oil phase, beeswax borax solution to the oil phase, you will see that the emulsion becomes thick first and suddenly thin down, and then it reverses. So if that reversal doesn't happen, then the emulsion is unstable. It is thick, but slowly water separates out from the emulsion. So beeswax borax emulsion is very tricky, and the process has to be optimized. One, not only the process is important, but again the quality of the raw material you used in the product, especially the other emulsifiers you use and the quality of the beeswax, all plays a very, very important role in the manufacture of cold cream based on beeswax and borax, right? So again, there was a controversy. The use of borax in skincare product is slowly withdrawn due to toxicity associated with the borax. Again, there was a lot of literature on the toxicity of borax. So the industry slowly have to move away from borax on a stay on skincare products, right? Owing to inconsistency in quality of beeswax and toxicity associated with borax, new cold cream formulations are not based on beeswax borax based emulsion, right? However, beeswax is used in the formula as an emollient. Synthetic beeswax is also available in the market, because if you use beeswax, you can't claim vegan. That is why synthetic beeswax is also available in the market, and some companies substitute synthetic beeswax for consistency in quality and vegan claim, right? So this is the status of beeswax borax based cold cream. So it started that the beeswax borax free cold cream stearic acid, cetyl alcohol, petrolatum, mineral oil, isopropyl maraschate forms the oil phase, glyceryl stearate also the oil phase, then propylene glycol is in the water phase, right? Propylene glycol, potassium hydroxide, water in the oil phase. So here the two emulsifiers are polysorbate 60. Polysorbate 60 is tween 60. Polyoxyethylene sorbitan monostearate is polysorbate 60. And of course, potassium hydroxide and stearic acid will form small amount of potassium stearate soap. So potassium stearate soap and polysorbate 60 are the emulsifiers in this product. It leads to water in oil type of emulsion, right? So this is the initial beeswax borax free emulsion, right? So there are synthetic beeswax, Synchrowax BB4, similar composition to beeswax, ideal choice for lipsticks to stabilize color, enhance gloss and facilitate mold remover, emulsifier, emulsion stabilizer for water in oil emulsion. So synthetic beeswax, its inky name is synthetic beeswax. So just I am showing this because this is not to make a beeswax borax emulsion, because beeswax borax is again a borax, you may not use. So beeswax can be used as a synthetic beeswax can be used as an emollient in the creams. So other simple formula which I would like to discuss is the beeswax borax free. Mineral oil 38%, synthetic beeswax, cetyl palmitate. Then cetyl palmitate came into the market. Cetyl palmitate is the primary constituent of spermaceti, right? We used spermaceti in the old creams, right? That is, cetyl palmitate now is made synthetically, right? We said from whales, sperm whale, spermaceti is obtained. And the main constituent of spermaceti is cetyl palmitate. So, cetyl palmitate with synthetic beeswax, mineral oil, in the oil phase taken in the main kettle, glycerol, water in the, of course, water phase added to the oil phase. Now, glyceryl monostearate self-emulsifying. So, there are three grades of glyceryl monostearate. Glyceryl monostearate non-self-emulsifying, that is just glyceryl monostearate. Glyceryl monostearate self-emulsifying contains soaps, additional soaps at 5% level in the GMS. So that is glyceryl monostearate self-emulsifying, because you can just put it in water and then emulsify, right? The soap in the glyceryl monostearate act as an emulsifier. Here also, the soap in the GMS self-emulsifying grade act as an emulsifier. There is another grade called glyceryl monostearate self-emulsifying acid stable. Usually in that, you have either sodium lauryl sulfate or PG100 stearate as the emulsifier there. Those emulsifiers are stable at acid pH. That is why GMS self-emulsifying acid stable grade. So they will say GMS SC acid stable. This is plain SC, this has soap. Now this is the simple beeswax borax free cold cream or a cleansing cream, whatever it is. So now this can be further modified, lot of modifications can be done in this. So you can reduce GMS self-emulsifying, you can use other non-ionic emulsifiers in this, right? and then to give the body to the cream, you can add little cetyl alcohol, you can add paraffin wax, right? So you can play with the emulsion, right? You can play with the emulsion with altering the ingredients, adding new ingredients, and then you can stabilize the cream, borax. So borax beeswax free cream, right? So this is what I want to discuss with you on Coltrim basically. So you can evolve from here the formulations for beeswax borax free Coltrim. Now range of creams, right? So from here range of creams evolved between dry matte feel of vanishing cream to oily occlusive effect of cold cream. Many emulsion formulations are developed to deliver range of sensory and skin benefits. Some of these formulations are designed as a base for cosmeceuticals, addressing conditions like skin aging signs, skin blemish, sun protection, xerosis, extreme dry skin, acne, all the conditions, right? So from here, lot of emulsions evolved. One extreme is vanishing cream, dry matte feel. The other extreme is cold cream, oily, occlusive feel. In between, there are lot of creams like moisturizing cream, night creams, cleansing creams, moisturizing lotions, right? So these were the things, and in the next section, next part 47, we will see what are the various categories of creams and lotions for various purposes, and see how the formulations can be tweaked to arrive at those formulations. I'm not going to give the entire formula, but we can see how ingredients can be tweaked to get those formulations right. Right? Thank you for listening to me in this part. Until the next session, I bid bye to you all. Be happy, be smiling, be safe. Thank you.